After a series of feisty cook-offs between some of the best chefs from India and Pakistan, 8 have been eliminated. 8 are still standing. They are the cream of the crop, but their mission just got harder. Because only one of them can be crowned the first emperor of Foodistan. On the first course of Foodistan, we've seen both team and solo contests. Each time the chefs cooked, they added points. In our last episode, 8 chefs with the lowest points had to leave the arena. Our 8 remaining chefs have crossed one big hurdle of Foodistan on their way to the Foodistan throne. But now that they're out of the kadhai, they suddenly find themselves in the tandoor. Their next cook-offs are going to be even harder. To serve the second course, here's Ali Khan.
Namaskar, adabars hai, and good evening, food lovers. As Ira has mentioned, the stakes in Act 2 of Foodistan have gotten even higher. The time given to each chef will be reduced. The level of competition is going to be tougher and they cannot repeat a recipe they have already cooked in the competition. The question is the repertoire of our Super 8 vast enough for this challenge?
And more importantly, will they continue to impress the judges? Please welcome Merrilise. Can I have some roti with that Parker?
Good evening, guys.
Hi, Merrilise. How are you?
Very excited. Next stage of the competition.
Absolutely.
Hoping things are going to hot up.
It's the second act and things are going to get hotter. Veer, I hate paneer. Sangvi.
Hi, Hira.
Hi, Veer. And Sonia, what's for dessert? Jahan.
Good evening, guys.
Good evening. Welcome, judges.
Thank you.
Now that we've met our judges, time to meet the first of our Super 8. He's one of the youngest chefs in Foodistan, a man who rose to the challenge of cooking with an unfamiliar game changer, the slippery banana, and came out on top. But what the judges really loved was the way he cooked his rice. Karan's explanation, he treats his rice like he treats his wife. How endearing is that? With oodles of love. To continue his love affair, here's the executive sous chef of the Leela Palace, Chef Karan Suri. Good to see you, Chief.
Good evening.
Hi, Karan.
Good evening.
Facing Karan Suri tonight is the Bengan King himself. He worked magic in his unassuming style with an equally unassuming vegetable and left the judges licking their fingers. He may be shy, humble, but he's a feisty competitor who defeated an award-winning chef from India to get to this stage. Please welcome sous chef from Islamabad Marriott, Chef Akhtar Rehman from Pakistan.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Namaskar.
Please. Chef Rehman ji, aaj kya umeed hai? Jeetne wale hain?
Yes, 199%.
199%. Sure confidence in this man. Karan?
Oh, it's confidence. Everybody has their own level of confidence. Some share it. I would like to show it in the kitchen. That's more important for me. And all the best for your confidence. And let the best man win today.
Time has been reduced. It's the second part of Foodistan. Not worried about 90 minutes instead of 120.
Who says? Of course I'm worried. No, but it's a challenge, like you said. You know, it's a new challenge now. So 90 minutes. Let's see what we cook up.
Chef Rehman and Chef Karan look very set to cook with new challenges, but are they ready to handle tonight's game changer? Remember, 2 of the 3 dishes they cook tonight must have that ingredient, our game changer. Right, Ali?
Absolutely, Ira. Tonight's game changer is not something you will find on most menus, which in fact makes it even more of a challenge for our chefs. Vegetarians may cringe, but hardcore carnivores like yours truly cannot get enough. The game changer tonight, Gurda, Kaleji and Beja. They may not look appetizing, but in the hands of our chefs, I'm sure they will taste delectable. Don't look so dejected. Don't look, well, Akhtar Rehman Saab is not looking phased at all. I tell you what, as always, we've got apprentices who are going to help you out. So please welcome Ajay from IICA Delhi and Vivek from IIHM Delhi. You guys know the drill. Whilst you're thinking on your feet, why don't you get into a huddle with your respective apprentices? Figure out what it is you're going to serve the judges, because you seriously have a bit of a challenge there. Ira?
Thanks, Ali. Judges. Now, tonight's game changer is definitely something I want everyone's reactions on. You all are looking very ready to start chatting immediately. Marilise?
I have to say, I love offal. I'm not mad about kidneys. Everything else, the brains, sweetbreads, livers, kidneys, bring it on. And I tell you something, I was in Pakistan. I had some fabulous offal. So I'm really hoping that the Pakistani side will give us something delicious.
Sonia?
Well, finally an exciting game changer. I'm actually ready to leap across. I love this. I grew up eating all this, so super excited.
Veer, sir, you're not looking too happy at all.
Well, actually, Ira, I'm sort of torn between two emotions. The first emotion is revulsion. I loathe this. These are the parts of the animal you should throw away. And the second is pity for this poor man, the poor Indian chef, who's not used to any of this and is going to have to cook it.
Thank you, Veer. I hope they can change your minds tonight, and I shall keep a bath bag handy just in case.
Good idea.
NDTV's cricket app. Android and iPhone. Fastest scorecard. Special analysis. And much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.